What's up, guys? What's going on? It's Dredd, and I'm back with another video where I'm Madden 23 today. Gonna hop in and do a rebuild with the Baltimore Ravens because, as a lot of you know, there's a ton of drama right now surrounding Lamar Jackson's contract situation. We hopped in, went straight to the Super Bowl, and now we're getting straight into the offseason. We're gonna trade him. I think it's going to be fun to see what happens if the Ravens do trade him. I don't know if I believe that's the most likely thing to happen. We'll probably get into that a little bit more later. But that is going to end up being what we're doing. We're going to trade him, see what we can get in Madden, and see how we can build this team around someone new. There's a lot that needs to be done, but there's a lot to be excited about as well. If you guys enjoy content like this, please drop a like and drop a sub for me. It means a lot and it really does help me out a ton. Let's get into it. Let's see what we can do. We're going to hop in, start by trading them, and then we'll get into the offseason. Okay, so we decided to ship Lamar Jackson off to the Atlanta Falcons. We get a couple of firsts, one this year, one next year, and AJ Terrell. In real life, this probably looks more like a couple of firsts, a couple of seconds, and maybe a lower level player, but we obviously can't include that much in Madden, so I wanted to get as much trade value as I can. AJ Terrell's a great player. If Lamar Jackson does go to the Falcons, I don't think they're going to trade an offensive lineman or a skill player like Drake London or Kyle Pitts for him, just because they're going to want to have whatever they can to make him happy. Obviously, I had to re-sign him to make this work, and then I had to end up trading him, so we turned off the salary cap because that was the only way really to get it to go through. So I am going to try to just stick to realistic moves, whatever we can do to make this team better that I think they may actually do. That's what we're going to do. We're not going to go too crazy because I do want to just be mindful and keep it somewhat realistic because that's what makes it fun. So looking at the roster, we could use another right guard. The rest of the offensive line is decent, especially the left side. I like that. Linderbaum, great rookie. Zeitler played really, really well this year, but he is getting older. We've got to be mindful of that. I like Dobbins. I'm not going to upgrade at running back probably. Bateman is really, really solid. He just needs chance and he needs to stay on the field. Duvernay is not a bad third or fourth guy, I guess, but we got to get another good receiver in there for whoever we bring in at quarterback. Andrews and Likely, great duo there. Love that. Love the defense. Really almost across the board. We're going to get Kyle Hamilton starting for sure. Great young rookie there. A lot of young talent to go around, but mixed in, they got some good vets to kind of help them out too. So I really like the setup they got. Bringing in AJ Terrell too just makes the secondary sick. We're going to try to move maybe Chuck Clark as well. Someone like that for maybe maybe outside linebacker help, maybe offensive line. I'm not sure. We'll see what we can do. We're going to look at free agency first though, see what we can bring in kind of cheap and see what we can do there. Looking at the free agent market, what are we going to have? We can look at quarterback, Geno Smith. I don't hate the idea of bringing someone like that in for 1 year. It's just not going to be it, though. Daniel Jones is a 72. Someone like Brissett, though, that makes a lot of sense. We're going to throw him some sort of cheap contract. I'm just going to leave it at that. Hopefully, he ends up coming through. I don't want to give him a long-term one. I don't want to give him a really expensive one. Looking at the receivers, Odell, probably the biggest playmaker out of all these guys, and to be honest, that's kind of what I think they need. It's already been rumored that he may go to Baltimore. I've seen that. It doesn't seem to be his destination. Madden's going to make us way overpay. We're signing the player for the sake of the player, not to a realistic contract. This isn't going to be a super long-term rebuild, so this deal is not close to what Odell would get. There's no way he'd be getting that big of a contract. But that's what we're going to throw him in the game. I don't hate the idea of Juju, but they just need someone better. They just need some bigger playmaker there. Odell, they can get that exciting player for significantly cheaper than what we gave him there. Offensive line, really the only position I'd consider upgrading is right tackle. I actually don't hate bringing Terrence Steele in. What kind of offers is he looking for? A two-year offer is not a bad deal for someone that's young and relatively talented. We'll throw him one. We're going to boost it a little bit. We're right there towards the top. A lot of guys fighting for him, though. Isaiah Wynn is actually probably a pretty decent guy, but in real life, he's going to cost way too much. Same with Caleb McGarry. Played really, really well this year. IRL, just going to cost way too much. So we'll leave those guys off the board. Looking at the defense, I just don't need, I don't feel the need to get anything except maybe a like left outside linebacker, right outside linebacker. I'm not bringing in someone as old as Van Noy. We'll stick with Bowser out there. Josh Allen would be sick, probably way out of our price point. So we're going to, free agency is different. Free agency is different. Sometimes I forget that. We're going to see how this goes. Hopefully we do get the guys that we want. Let's evaluate offers. We got someone. Brissett is going to come home. That's good. He's going to be our starter for the time being. We'll see what we do. We miss out on a couple of guys here. That is unfortunate. Odell not going to come home. That's actually really tough. We gotta try something else at receiver here now. Let's see. What do we have? Yikes. All right. I like Shepard as a slot. Just can't stay healthy. Speed element, Robbie Anderson, but just not quite the type of player I'm looking for. I just don't see a lot of guys that I love. Isaiah Hodgins played great for the Giants this year. Not going to be it. Same with Richie James. There's no one that's... we'll go get Rashid Shaheed. He'll be our number four guy. I kind of like having him. He actually played really well down the stretch for the Saints. He had some big-time splash plays. Just another player that's not going to be that significant, though. We got to get more in there. Looks like Terrence Steele might still be here. Terrence Steele's not... Are these guys getting any offers? Okay, they are. We're going to leave them off. We're not going to go for them. It just doesn't make sense. It's not realistic. I left free agency again. We're going to try to sign free agents here. We're going to try to skip to the next week. That's what I mean. My bad. Let's see. Did we get anyone? We do get Shaheed. And seeing Miles Sanders sitting there staring at us still, that feels like a very Baltimore pickup. And he's going to be a boost. I don't mind giving him a deal in that range. He kind of feels like a fit for what they try to do. We might as well try to go out and get someone in there to help us out. And he's going to get a lot better offers now. We're not going to boost it any more than we already did. I'm trying to keep it realistic. I know it's a little bit boring, but that's what I'm trying to do, man. That's what I'm trying to do. I like the moves we made. I don't think Baltimore goes out and tries to spend a ton of money this year. They've got guys in there, a lot of young talent. And now they have, with this trade for Lamar, they have a place to build from in the draft. They have the picks to make something happen. Let's see if we can get this done. We actually got Miles Sanders. Cool. So we did bring him in. I didn't expect him to go through. He had a better contract offer from our rival, the Bengals, who may move on from Joe Mixon. That'd be a huge move for the Bengals. Kind of franchise altering there. Personally, I'm surprised by it, but at the same time, it kind of makes sense. So we get Miles Sanders. That's a weapon for whoever our quarterback is. He's got a couple of good tight ends. He's got some decent receivers. The offensive line isn't terrible. We're putting our quarterback in a good spot. I believe injuries are off. That's going to help a ton. Now we're going to start the draft. And now I have to make the very, very, very big decision of who I want to go with here. This is tough. This is really tough. I think IRL, the Bears trade out of this spot. I think that's the only thing that makes sense. I don't think if the Ravens trade Jackson that they will make this move up. They're going to take Miles Murphy. Wow. The Texans certainly aren't trading their pick. There's no way Bryce Young goes there. The Cardinals could look to trade. We could look to leapfrog up here. I think we're going to let one more quarterback go. I don't know who it is. And that's big. Jalen Carter goes there. That makes sense as well. CJ Stroud had to go there. Now is where I think we need to move up. Let's look at the draft board first. I have a quarterback in mind. It just makes too much sense, and I know everybody's going to be like, oh, you're just going to put him in the same spot they were already in, except with a downgrade. That is exactly what's happening, but he's going to be a lot cheaper. So we're going to try to move up here with, I just clicked the same thing, with Seattle. I'll come back to y'all once we have a trade in place. All right, so I actually really like this move for us. We don't have a second round pick this year, so we're going to trade up only three spots. We send them our first next year for their second this year. I'm hoping that we're going to be pretty good, so I'm hoping our first is kind of late. And this second is very, very early. So I like it. I actually really think that's a good trade. That's better value than I was expecting to get out of this. I really liked that move to move up now. We're going to come in, make our selection here, and we're going to take Anthony Richardson. He feels like a Lamar clone, except maybe more athletic and maybe with a stronger arm, but much less refined as a passer. Much less experienced. Those are things that we're going to have to deal with and try to combat. in his development here. We got to try to put him in the position to succeed. Tyree Wilson goes number 6. And then we're going to have Noah Sewell all the way up at number 7. And Will Anderson falls to 8. That's crazy. He's going to be a top 4 pick, I would almost guarantee, unless there's a run on quarterbacks. Brian Breesy, someone that was huge. Everybody loved him for the last half decade, I guess. He's kind of fallen off. People have been watching him since high school. But he just never did quite enough at Clemson. Paris Johnson goes there. Quentin Johnson, someone I would have looked at, but just doesn't seem to fit the scheme. Great receiver, though. I think he's going to be really good. Levis goes to the Packers to replace Aaron Rodgers. I don't think Levis is going to be good. I don't think Levis is it, personally. Not a guy I'm high on. Michael Mayer there would have been a nice guy to add if we didn't already have a ton of tight ends. I'm looking at weapons now. Ringo and Smith, two good corner prospects. Jordan Addison goes there. Not happy about that. And Jackson Smith. That's not good. All right. We are left scrambling here. Wow. Okay. So what can we do? A backfield of... I can't do that. I can't do that. That's so tempting, but I could do that. Oh, I could do that. I could do that. We could put Bijan in the backfield with Anthony Richardson and then just wait to take like a Zay Flowers in the top of the second. Ooh. Darnell Washington, nice prospect, but I kind of somehow feel like he's not going to go in the first. Josh Downs I like, but he's just a little bit too small for me. I'd like to get someone a little bit bigger out there. Not high on Hyatt at all. I'm really... Where's Zay Flowers? Zay Flowers is all the way down here. Kayshon Boutte, too. A lot of potential. But it's tough. He definitely didn't play as well this year, but that's not all his fault. This is tough. DeJuan Jones, if we wanted to go for a right tackle, I don't hate that. There's so much we could do. And since we don't need anything on defense, we're really kind of freed up to do whatever we want. So I think we're going to go out. We're going to get one of the best players in this class. This is stupid, but this is fun, man. Bijan Robinson is going to be next level. We just picked up Miles Sanders. I know. We're going to have to figure something out. I don't know what we're going to do. But that's just so exciting. That's so fun. Couldn't pass it up. Darnell Washington almost falls to us at the second, but we wouldn't take another tight end anyways. We got to go receiver here. And this is such a tough choice between Boot and Flowers. Both these guys look awesome on tape. I don't love Flowers' size, but I've taken Boot before, and I just want to see what Flowers does. I want to see what he's like. We're going to take Zay Flowers here. He's going to be our number 2 receiver. Hopefully he turns into something. This is a very, very weird draft. Not at all how I expected this to go, but I'm having fun with it. So let's just keep going. Let's keep moving. See what we can do. Let's see. Is there anyone? Devon Witherspoon is definitely not going to be available here at IRL. He's definitely going to go earlier than that. Jarrett and Perry probably go earlier as well. Zach Evans wouldn't have been a bad pick. Zion Nelson could go that direction, but I kind of do want to just build around around Anthony Richardson. So we're going to go for right tackle, the highest rated one. As long as his pass block isn't terrible, he's going to be good. It looked like from his ratings. We're going to call that it for the draft. This did not go as I planned. Getting Jordan Addison and Jackson Smith and Jigba sniped right there really hurt a lot. That threw off our draft, but hopefully we still put Richardson in a place to succeed. We should have a strong ground game and enough weapons for him to do something. I'm going to set the lineup, show you guys, and then we'll hop into the season. Well, this is really dumb. I don't know how I got this to work. I don't know why I did this, but we do get Jackson Smith and Jigba now. He's going to be our receiver. Shipped off Sanders and Chuck Clark, guys that I said I was probably going to trade. IRL, I know the Ravens do like those kind of three safety sets, but we were able to move off them really easy, and I feel like, wow, we're going to start a lot of young guys. I feel like it just kind of makes sense for us to get Bijan in there. It's the right thing to do. Chuck Clark is expendable. I mean, we got three. Actually, the computer drafted Witherspoon for us too, so we actually have 4 good corners now. I just don't envision a lot of three safety sets. I like what we have here. I love this team. This is what we're rolling with. It's going to be really good. Let's set those specialists. I'm sorry, Dobbins. You're getting replaced. This team is going to be fun. It's going to be really fun. I'm excited to see how we develop. I'm going to simulate to the playoffs. Hopefully, we do make them this year. And then hopefully we can make a run towards the Super Bowl. So first year is over and we did kind of flop a little bit. 6-11 isn't great, but it's just, you know, it's not that surprising when the team is as young as it is. Anthony Richardson struggled. 18 picks is a ton. Bijan did well. Richardson did a decent amount running. Still need a lot more out of him though. JSN, pretty good. Pretty mid for the rest of the team. That's unfortunate. Defensively, 11 for Madubuike, yes, just nothing stands out as incredible. 4 for Marcus Williams is nice. I mean, we're solid, but we're just not great. We're going to hop quickly into the offseason, fly through this, and then try to hit up another season as well, see what we can do there. So this is like a totally stacked free agency class, but it just doesn't have anyone that we really need or want. We went after Josh Uche, and we did not get him. So we're going to end up going to the draft and looking probably for an outside backer there. There's a million good receivers in free agency. We just didn't want to pay any of them. So we're just going to move on. I like our crew. I like our squad with Bateman, JSN, and Flowers. They need to develop more, and same with Anthony Richardson. But as long as we can do that, we're going to be in a really good spot. We just got to do that. We got to get this team going. So hopefully we can. We're moving to the draft here, and I'll see you there. All right, starting the draft. We should have a couple of picks here, but we traded ours away, which ended up being the earlier one. And Lamar gets his revenge and goes to the Super Bowl. That's not good. That's not good at all. We do need a right guard as well. I forgot. We need a right guard. Dang. Okay, so we gotta get right guard and we gotta get, why does this not look right? This is right, okay. Need a right guard and an outside linebacker. Let's just check all the interior guys. We can move people around, so we probably will move people around. We're gonna look at, I need to remember Samson for later. He has really nice numbers. He could be really good too, jeez. All right. I guess we're going to go after Chase Swinney. Hope he can be solid for us. Not great, but not terrible. We'll take it. That hidden development is nice. That helps a lot for sure. We're going to skip ahead. Next user pick is the fifth pick in the second round. Yeah, second rounds. I got to replace Bowser on defense. That's the guy that I'm... That's the weak point. But I just don't know if we have the guys. Honestly, I don't know. It's not a fit at all, so we're not going to be able to. We're just going to keep going crazy on offensive line and hope we really hit with one of them. We're going to go with Murray here. Hopefully he ends up decent as well. Another hidden development, not very strong. That's concerning, especially at center. Going to have to deal with those big boys up the middle. Hopefully we can make it work. We're going to try to hit that left guard now, and then we're going to move on to the season and hope we can ball out and get a dub. I'd love to have a chance to actually show off in the Super Bowl because I think this team is going to be so fun. Colin Sampson, last pick here. It seems like he's decent. Again, just not crazy strong. We got hidden development on all three of them, though, so whichever one's best is definitely going to get the start. We're gonna set up this roster and simulate to the playoffs. Hopefully we make them. So, another year goes by, and we still struggle seriously. That was really bad. It just did not work. It looks like Anthony Richardson just didn't develop. 30-10 is actually better. It's a lot better. 14 touchdowns for Bijan, another 8 for Anthony Richardson. No fumbles between the two at all. Mark Andrews leads the team. JSN and Bateman both played well. Zay Flowers did not do much. Defense, Roquan Smith with a potential defensive player of the year season. No pressure. Wow. All that young talent on the defensive line, and we still can't get anything going. So I think, obviously, we also need to take a quick look at how Lamar played. Let's see how he did and if he played as well as he deserves. 5,000 yards, 36 touchdowns, 10 interceptions. Obviously, his rushing numbers go down with the playbook and everything. Jacoby Myers is their number one receiver. That's funny. Really, he played great, which is kind of to be expected. I have no idea who Avery Overstreet is. This is a little frustrating. I feel like we put together a good team. We just relied on Anthony Richardson, and it didn't happen. Obviously, he would, after a 30-touchdown season, I guess 38-touchdown season, including his rushing touchdowns, he's going to develop a lot. We just don't have time to sit here for forever. But let's see, another 7 upgrade points for Bijan, 6 for Chase Swinney, only 4 for Anthony Richardson. It just doesn't seem like it's destined to happen. And a lot of the franchises I play with him, he develops like crazy. And I expected him to be exceptionally good in Baltimore's playbook. But he just wasn't. We have a great roster, 89s across the board. But whenever you move on from a quarterback like Lamar Jackson, it does complicate things a lot. It really doesn't put you in the position to succeed, which is unfortunate. I think we kind of had to see it coming a little bit, but let's simulate to the Super Bowl. Why not? It was fun, though. It was fun. I like this idea. I don't know if the Ravens trade Lamar. I really have no idea what to expect from them at this point. Colts versus the Seahawks. What? I think Lamar's a great player. He's a great quarterback. He has had injury issues. He has struggled when it comes down to it in the big moments, but you just don't get a quarterback like him often. They just don't come around often enough for you to let him go. Unless you get a fortune. So unless they're getting multiple firsts, seconds, and maybe a young player, like a Russell Wilson type deal, I don't see it being possible. But we'll see. We'll see. I really have no idea what to expect. Ravens fans, drop a comment. Let me know what you guys expect. Let me know what you guys want. Do you want to see Lamar go, or do you want to see him stay? Always love seeing the comments. Sorry I could not get it done today, but I hope you guys keep coming back to the channel, and I'll see you all in the next one. Peace, guys.